The Enola Holmes movie, based on the Enola Holmes book series, which I have not read but would now like to, is basically the fourth wall breaking teen girl self-insert fanfic of Sherlock Holmes that I did not know I wanted. Spoilers. But when I watched it, I came away with one big question that I felt compelled to answer. Would a corset really stop a knife? My name is Jill Bearup, and on this channel our tagline, yes we have a tagline, is storytelling through fight scenes. Some people think of fight scenes as a lot of sound and fury signifying not much at all, and in some cases they are not wrong, but a good fight scene should inform us about plot and or characters. And a great fight scene will do both those things and give us something to remember. Preferably something that ties in with the themes or plot or characters in the story. Enter Enola's whalebone corset. The scene is this. Enola Holmes, little sister of Sherlock and Mycroft Holmes, has made her way to London in search of her missing mother. She is in the East End when she is unexpectedly attacked by Bowler Hat, aka Linthorn. Linthorn is looking for Tewkesbury, whose life Enola saved earlier in the film. Linthorn dunks Enola repeatedly in a barrel of water by way of an interrogation technique. She escapes. They have a hand-to-hand fight which averages one cut per second and is intercut with another fight, this one Enola learning to fight from her mother. But anyway, Enola attempts the corkscrew for the second time in the film, fails, is shoved back into the suffragette building, Linthorn follows her, pulls a knife, and stabs her. Everything goes black. But wait, he pulls back, confused, the knife having failed to penetrate, and Enola rips back the fabric of her dress to reveal that her corset has saved the day. There are a couple of fight details I really like. I like that she pins her hair back before they get into the fight. I like the rule of three that they set up with the corkscrew, and I love that they gave the corset this random starring role. But when I saw this scene, my first thought was, would that actually work? Turns out, actually, it might. One shouldn't rely on one's underwear to protect one from stabbing weapons, but the math says it's a solid maybe, and there are historical examples of women being saved by their corsets. We'll come back to the maths. Mary Sarah Phillips was a poor woman from Barnsley who separated from her husband Charles in 1888. After coming over to her parents' house a bunch of times to plead for her to come back, he abducted their baby. Yeah, great guy. Some days later, like over a week later, she got a note saying that the baby was ill and that she should meet Charles in a particular park. So she took along minor friend Thomas Siddons and off they went. Charles Phillips was reportedly so enraged by seeing her with a man that he ran up, stabbed her in the back, knocked her to the ground, and then stabbed her repeatedly. Until the blade of the knife broke, in fact. Charles Phillips was, incidentally, apprehended after a female passerby saw what he was doing, ran up, and clocked him on the head with her umbrella. I feel like I might have previously mentioned that umbrellas are quite useful as improvised weapons. Anyway, they later discovered that Mary's corset had deflected no fewer than 8 knife strikes. So yeah, her life was almost certainly saved by her corset. Enola is wearing a whalebone corset, which is probably what Mary Sarah Phillips had on. Steel-boned corsets have been known to deflect bullets. See, for example, the case of Edith Bowman in 1890 in Omaha, Nebraska. So anecdotally, it's not that unreasonable for a corset to turn aside a single knife blow. But maybe you are not interested in historical anecdotes because you are a scientist. Alright, back of the envelope maths time. A Kevlar vest will stop a 9mm bullet, meaning it can cope with at least 467 joules of energy. Baleen, which is what we mean when we say whalebone in this context, is about 3% as strong as Kevlar and so can probably cope with about 14 joules. After which we would assume that it would crack, which it did. A reasonable energy estimate for a stab by a male assailant, 24 to 33 joules. Good start. We like this. Assuming at this point that the blade can't actually do any stabbing because the structure of the corset is preventing it from pushing the fibers further apart and reaching Enola's skin, there are only about 19 joules remaining at a maximum. Given that the silk dress and the fabric over the baleen will require energy to break through, given that the corset is spreading the force of the blow over a wider area, given that a punch for comparison purposes carries about 150 joules of energy, and given that someone trained in fighting would try to ride the blow backwards, she should be fine. All this to say, it's not unreasonable at all to assume that if you stab someone in one of the bones of their whalebone corset, you will crack the whalebone, but you may well leave the person underneath unharmed. That being said, kids, don't try this at home. So instead of conducting dangerous and illegal experiments, I have two suggestions which you may prefer. The first one is, if you're looking at these numbers and thinking, I don't know, is to leave a comment with your own calculations. If you're not into that, I understand, because most people don't actually want to do maths in their leisure time. In which case, subscribe and maybe watch some more videos. Hope to see you soon.